Hi friends, welcome to Discovery Agriculture YouTube channel. If you are not yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe now. In this video, I'll give complete informations about drumstick farming. Introduction to Moringa. The drumstick is a vegetable plant grown for its edible tender pods, leaves, and flowers that are nutrient-rich. The drumstick tree is a softwood tree and is native to India. The trees are grown in the tropical and subtropical regions around the world. The drumstick tree is called by many English common names for its various qualities such as moringa, drumstick tree, benzoil tree, and horseradish tree. The tree is a fast-growing, drought-resistant and perennial vegetable tree. The trees are small to medium-sized of about 10 to 12 meter height. The trunk of the tree can reach a diameter of 35 to 45 centimeter and is thick, corky with fragile stems. The tree branches are drooping with leaves that are trypinnate with elliptic leaflets. The pods are long, pendulous, reaching 20 to 80 cm in length. The seeds inside are trigonous in shape with wings on angles. The tree bears yellowish, creamy white flowers that are bisexual with sweet fragrance growing on slender, hairy stalks. The flowering of the tree varies from region to region in India and is greatly influenced by rain, soil and other environmental conditions. Flowering occurs once a year between January to August in South Indian conditions. In central Kerala, peak flowering starts in December to January. In southern parts of Kerala, it is February to March. Coimbatore, it is March to May. And in Bangalore, it is July to September. In conditions with constant seasonal temperatures and with consistent rainfall, flowering can happen twice or throughout the year. The trees are cut down to 1 to 2 meters under commercial farming by farmers as the plants regrow with pods and leaves within arm's reach. The trees start bearing pods from the 6th month after planting. The pods of the drumstick tree are a very popular vegetable with distinctly inviting flavor and its leaves are used in dry seasons in South Indian cuisine. Pods are nutrient-rich in carotene 110 mg, vitamin C 120 mg, phosphorus 110 mg and minerals such as potassium 259 mg, chlorine 423 mg, magnesium 28 mg etc. in every 100 grams. Scientific or botanical name of drumstick. The botanical or scientific name of drumstick tree is Moringulifera Lam, and the plant comes from the family Moringaceae. Other names of drumstick tree. Moringa tree, the name given for its long, slender, triangular seed pods. Horseradish tree, the name given for its root tastes resembling horseradish taste. Benzoil tree or benzoil tree, the name given to its oil extracted from moringa seeds. Drumstick varieties or drumstick cultivars. Drumstick varieties are classified into perennial and annual types. 1. Perennial type. These varieties have been in cultivation for centuries. In India, they are typically propagated through cuttings. These trees are less resistant to pests and diseases while requiring greater rainfall. The trees take a long time to grow and are usually not preferred for commercial cultivation. 2. Annual types. These trees are the common and regular trees that we found in the current cultivation developed through plant breeding research. They are propagated through seeds offering fast growth, early maturity, higher yields, and adapts to various soil and climatic conditions. Climate and soil requirement for drumstick farming. The plants can be grown in a wide range of soils. Well-drained sandy loam soils with a pH of 6 to 7 are ideal soil conditions, while red soils are recommended as high seedling vigor was observed. The plants grow well in tropical and subtropical climatic conditions. The tree is susceptible to frost and shedding of flowers is observed when day temperature exceeds 40 degrees C. The ideal temperature with luxuriant plant growth is observed at 25 degrees to 35 degrees Celsius. Land preparation for drumstick farming. Deep plowing of the land is required for drumstick farming. About 20 tons of farmyard manure is incorporated per hectare at the time of the last plowing of the land. For perennial cultivars, pit size of about 45 × 45 × 45 cm is dug at every 6 × 6 m spacing, while for annual cultivars, pits are dug at 2.5 × 2.5 m spacing. For farming of drumstick leaves, 1 × 1 m spacing can be maintained. Each pit is filled with a well-mixed mixture of soil, 10 to 15 kg of farmyard manure or compost along with 100 grams of nitrogen, 200 grams of phosphorus, and 50 grams of potassium before the onset of monsoon. Seed treatment in drumstick farming. Treat the seeds with approved biopesticides or chemicals before sowing, as this will help control seed-borne diseases. Soak the seeds overnight in water and sow the seeds on the other day. This will help in early germination. Seed treated with 100 grams of Azospirillin for 650 grams of seeds resulted in early germination with increased seedling vigor and growth. Propagation in drumstick farming. There are two types of propagation in drumstick farming. 1. Seed propagation. This method is suitable for annual cultivar types. Seeds are sown in 2 to 3 cm depth in each pit. Under regular and proper irrigation, germination happens after 8 to 10 days. 2. Stem cutting. This method is suitable for perennial cultivar types. When trees stop producing pods, cut off the branches for growing new trees, and this will promote fresh growth. Cut branches that are 5 to 12 cm in diameter and 100 to 150 cm in length for planting in each pit. Application of cow dung on the top end of the cutting will protect the cut branches from pests and diseases at the time of planting. For proper root and plant growth, place 1/3 part of the cut branch inside the soil pit. 3. Nursery. Seeds are planted in nursery beds or in 15 by 7 cm polyethylene bags in the months May to June. Soil must be well mixed with organic manure at 2:1 ratio. After 8 to 10 days, the process of germination takes place and 30 to 40 days old seedlings are ready for transplanting in the mainland. About 600 to 700 grams of seeds are required for a hectare land. It is recommended to raise a few extra plants in polythene bags for the purpose of gap filling in the mainland. Irrigation in drumstick. Farming drumstick plants can withstand drought conditions for up to 6 months. They require minimum irrigation for proper growth. Soil conditions such as too dry or too wet will lead to flower drop. Optimum soil moisture should be maintained for more yields. Irrigate fields once in a week up to 3 months, followed by once in 10 to 12 days thereafter. Irrigation may not be necessary during the rainy season. Maintain adequate soil moisture during the flowering period and avoid stagnation of water. Manures and fertilizer in drumstick farming. After the third month of sowing or planting, 100 grams of urea, 100 grams of superphosphate, and 50 grams of murate of potash should be applied to each plant or pit. During flowering time, apply 100 grams of urea per plant or pit. Heavy irrigation should be provided at the time of pod development. Intercultural operations in drumstick. Weeding. Since the drumstick plants are widely spaced, manual and mechanical intercultural operations can be undertaken. Regular weeding with a hoe will loosen the topsoil for good aeration and removes the unwanted plants and weeds. Fields having older drumstick trees are recommended to weed 4 times a year. For shallow rooted weeds, 3 to 4 times of hoeing is required each time after irrigation. When fields are infested with numerous weed, mow the fields before weeds produce seed as close to the ground as possible. Those drumstick plantations that not weeded properly will produce fewer leaves and flowers, and the leaves begin to yellow at the base. Application of registered herbicides at timely intervals will help to control the growth of weeds. Pruning. Drumstick tree branches grow long and vertically, producing leaves and pods. When branches left growing naturally, the pod production becomes low. The trees tend to grow 10 to 12 meters long, making harvesting of fruits difficult. Pruning makes young tree branch laterally, making them short and bushy by pinching the terminal bud on the central stem when the trees are between 1 to 2 meters in height. Pruning can be undertaken on a regular basis after each harvest. Pruning helps the tree to produce more branches, leading to more flowering and fruits. Harvesting will be made easy as tender pods and leaves will be in comfortable reach. Yield in drumstick farming. Depending on the variety of the tree planted and farming practices, trees can give 2 fresh leaf harvests in a year. So also, depending on tree varieties, fresh pods can be harvested twice in a year. Under good cultivation, a drumstick plantation can yield 18 to 20 tons of pods per acre per year and 25 to 32 tons of fresh leaves per acre in a year. Hope you like this video. Share this video with all friends and don't forget to subscribe Discovery Agriculture YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video. Have a good day.